young people step in at the last minute to help us out with music, since our regular feature, once monthly, Kat Curley and her band are indisposed this evening. So Hunter and Sammy and Phoenix have all sung with us on previous occasions, and I'd like to welcome them here to our beautiful new space. And I don't know if you are familiar with our percussion, but his name is Scott McLeod, and you may recognize the sound coming from these things over here.
Thank you. A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus returned to the temple and began teaching, the leading priest and the elders came up to him. They demanded, "By what authority are you doing all these things? Who gave you the right?" "I'll tell you by what authority I do these things, if you answer one question," Jesus replied. "Did John's authority to baptize come from heaven, or was it merely human?" They talked it over among themselves. "If we say it was from heaven, he will ask us why we didn't believe John. But if we say it was merely human, we'll be mobbed because the people believed John. They believed John was a prophet." So they finally replied, "We don't know." And Jesus responded, "Then I won't tell you by what authority I do these things. But what do you think about this? A man with two sons told the older boy, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' The son answered, 'No, I won't go.' But later he changed his mind and went anyway. Then the father told the other son, 'You go.' And he said, 'Yes, sir, I will.' But he didn't go. Which of the two obeyed his father?" They replied, "The first." Then Jesus explained this meaning: "I tell you the truth, corrupt tax collectors and prostitutes will get into the kingdom of God before you do. For John the Baptist came and showed you the right way to live, but you didn't believe him, while the tax collectors and prostitutes did. And even when you saw this happening, you refused to believe him and to repent of your sins." Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
joy. Soon you'll grow and the world will know you're no ordinary boy. You're the love of the Father, the hope of the nations, comfort for all those who mourn. You are strength for the weary, the joy of the meek, good news for everyone. Eyes so bright, full of God's own light, tiny hands reach out with love. Soon you'll grow and the world will know new light dawns from heaven above. You're the love of the Father, the hope of the nations, comfort for all those who mourn. You are strength for the weary, the joy of the meek, good news for everyone. Child unflawed, sweet self-skin on God, how I love to hold you near. Soon you'll grow and the world will know our Almighty God is here. You're the love of the Father, the hope of the nations, comfort for all those who mourn. You are strength for the weary, the joy of the meek, good news for everyone.
And the Moffitt family, Cheryl, Catherine, and all of those who are on our heart this evening. God of life, you give us these gifts of the earth, these resources of our life and our labor. Take them, offered with our gratitude, and use them to set a table that will heal the whole creation. Through Jesus, our light and our Savior. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Source of the seed, the growth, and the harvest, changer of seasons, creator of all, to you we give our thanks and praise. For lettuce, potatoes, tomatoes, and corn. For strawberries, cherries, peaches, and grapes. For rain after drought, sunshine after clouds, for all and everything. We sing our thanks and praise. And how can we ever thank you enough for Jesus Christ, your love personified, who on the worst night of his life gave thanks? thanks for the bread and body he could give, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body broken for you." He took the cup of wine and once again gave thanks to you and gave the cup to them, saying, "This is my blood shed for you. When you drink it, remember me." So remembering his planting and harvest, his death and resurrection, we offer you this bread and wine, praying for the Holy Spirit's blessing on these gifts, that they may yield a bumper crop of faith, hope, and love in our hearts. We pray that in our best days and worst nights, we will always have grateful hearts, trusting you to turn our feeble thanks to worthy songs of praise to you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Gathering all of our prayers and praises into one, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. This is the table at which God is host and all are welcome guests. The gifts of God for the whole people of God.
David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift, the baffled king composing
singing one last one.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, Phoenix and Sammy and Mari and Hunter and Scott, for the wonderful music this evening. I have to say, that last song, it takes me right back to grade 9. And I thank you, Phoenix, for helping me to see that tonight in a whole new way as a song of praise. I can hear God singing that song to us. I can hear us singing it in return to God as a song of praise. So thank you. I had never heard it that way before. A couple of announcements. Following the service tonight, we do have a Bible study for young adults. If there's any others who want to fall into that category and want to join in the Bible study, grab a cup of coffee and get to continue the conversation and fellowship. So we're looking forward to that. This coming Sunday, there are some special guests coming to our church. It is Bring Your Pet to Church Sunday, and we're going to be having a blessing of the animals. So come to our 10 o'clock service, bring your furry friends, and we look forward to a holy ruckus in our sanctuary this coming Sunday. Are there any other announcements? Okay, final song. Was Jesus' parting gift to his disciples. As a sign of that blessing going out into the world in his name, we share a sign of peace with one another, exchanging handshakes or high fives or hugs or other appropriate greetings. The peace of Christ be always with you.